My name is Maggie. I'm a designer from the Philadelphia area. In this video, we're going to take a look at what is a domain name. Computers talk and identify with one another with numbers over a network through IP addresses. Whereas when we look at the world of humans, humans use names and words to identify and communicate. We can say that a domain name is used to translate these numbers into names for humans to remember. A domain name is a way to bridge the communication gap between humans and computers. When a domain name is chosen, it is registered, and it can be used for a website and/or an email account. Domain names are what users type into their browsers to find your website. They are referred to as web addresses, such as Codecademy, Google, Lodash, GitHub. What is not a domain name? A domain name is not your website. A domain name is not email. But you cannot have an email account or a website without a domain. How does it all work? DNS is used to translate the IP addresses into numbers. We type a domain name into our web browser. Our computer first checks its cache memory to see if it can pull the website. If it cannot do that, it goes to the resolver, our internet service provider. If it cannot find it here, it goes to the root server. When we look at the hierarchy of our domain name search, our internet search, the root server is the top of this hierarchy. There are 13 root servers strategically placed throughout the world, and they're operated by different organizations. Each set has their own unique IP addresses. So the root server receives our query for the IP address for the site that it is searching for. The root server does not know the domain, but it knows where to send the resolver to find it. It goes back to the resolver, and then it sends it to the TLD server, the top level domain server. The TLD server stores the address information for the top level domains. Then from the TLD server goes back to the resolver server and is sent to the name server. The name server is responsible for knowing everything about the domain, including the IP address. The name server is the final authority. It will send back to the computer with the site. And your computer will store this in its cache memory. So the next time it will not have to go through all of these steps again. Let's take a closer look at domain name examples. We all are probably familiar with our extensions .com, .org, .edu, .net, .biz, .info, and there are even more. .com is the most popular. We know if we've ever been in a school, .edu is used, governmental websites, .gov, and .org usually used for nonprofits. You also may be aware that there are country codes. FR for France, CN for China, DE for Germany. When we think about choosing a domain name, it is best to keep it short and easy to remember. Again, we know that humans remember names, so if it's short and rememberable, they're more likely to remember the domain and not make mistakes when they type it in. So what is the difference between a domain name and web hosting? We begin when we are building a website by getting a domain name. And we also then have to get hosting for our site. Hosting is the storage area, and it's where we post the content of our website. A web host or web hosting is a service provider. This service provider has the technologies that are needed for a website to be viewed on the internet. Our websites are stored on special computers called servers. Then we take a look at the domain name. Our domains point to our website that is hosted on a server. When making a website that you've built live on the web, you would get a domain name and a web hosting package to do so. Thanks for watching. Join the conversation by subscribing below. And if you'd like to take your skills to the next level, join Codecademy today.